Unlike the Z and T tests, the distribution of the F statistics is not symmetrical. The F distribution is positively skewed, meaning it peaks on the left side and is stretched out to the right side. This distribution peaks at 1. This is because if there are no differences in the population means, in other words, the between group variability is expected to be 0, then the mean of each sample will still likely differ by chance. Since the difference then is due to chance, the same way that each subject in each sample differs by chance, as measured by the within group variability, then the between group variability and within group variability will be the same. Therefore, when we divide them, we get 1, and that's where this distribution peaks. Also note that when we're doing an F test, this will always be non-directional, whereas when we were doing the Z and T tests, our alternative hypothesis could have been that one population mean is less than another. With the F test, we only know if there's a significant difference. Our critical region will always be out here in the upper tail. But everything else is essentially the same. We choose an alpha level, usually 0.05, and then we find out if our F statistic lies in the critical region or not. If it lies in the critical region, we know that at least 2 population means will be significantly different.